what is retrieve operation, and now we'll be moving on to delete operation and update operation. So once again, let us review. So you say all users, and here you are able to retrieve the data, and when you click on any option, so we will show the options to the user: view user, delete user, and update user. On view user, you are displaying the data in the form of your alert dialog, and now I need to say click and delete user. So something should happen when you click on delete user. Let's see how we can do that. In my delete user over here, I am going to say void ask for deletion. So I want to ask for deletion first of all. That are you really sure that you want to delete this record? In order to do that, I'll just copy and paste the dialog from above, and I will say delete plus the user dot get name, and in my message part, are you sure to delete the record, and you put a question mark. Now there can be two buttons. The positive buttons can be delete with a new on click listener, and there can be one more button, set of negative button, which can go like cancel, and what should happen on cancel? Nothing. So I will say, if user is going to say case 1, you ask for deletion. When you ask for deletion, you will show one alert dialog to the user, and now when the user clicks on delete, now the user should really be deleted. So I will create one more method now, and this method goes like delete user. Now you need to delete user from the content provider. In order to delete the user from the content provider, so in my content provider, I got, let me open the architecture. So we got this content provider over here, and you need to call the method called delete. So you will say resolver.delete, and then this delete will call internally the delete method of content provider, and content provider's delete method will further call the delete method of SQLite database. So the structure remains the same. Now come back and let us try to do delete operation. I will first of all create a string called where. So what you want to delete, that matters, right? So I'll say string where assign util dot column underscore id is equal to plus user dot get the id. So I got one condition where the left hand side is the column name and right hand side is the id. So it's a where condition more or less. So if it is supposed to be a text over here, then you put it in the single quotes. Now you say resolver dot delete. You call resolver dot delete, and you now need to pass the first guy as util dot URI, and the second input as where condition, and third guy goes null. When you say resolver dot delete, you are passing URI, which contains which content provider and which table. Then you got the where condition, which specifies where ID is this guy over here. Now what user.getID will give? User.getID is going to give the ID of that user which you have clicked, right? Now resolver.delete over here is going to execute the delete method of content provider. In the content provider's delete method, I will extract the table name, which goes like URI dot get the last path segment. And now you say SQLite database dot delete. Now this delete is table name. Then you got selection, and the last attribute goes like null. So this selection over here is the where condition which you passed in your all users activity. Now the delete method is going to return you an integer. So rows deleted as in 1 or 0, right? So the number of rows deleted, and then you return back the same guy I over here. So whenever you return this guy I, this will be returned to the resolvers delete over here, and now you can say toast dot make text this comma, you can say user dot get the name deleted from DB, and you can say length long dot show, right? So deleted from DB. So it means when user is going to click on delete, you just say delete the user. So let's see the hierarchy. User clicks on item, you show the options. When user clicks on delete user, it's the case one, you ask for deletion. In my ask for deletion, I am creating an alert dialog. If user is going to click on delete, I'll say delete user, and delete user will create a where condition, and it will say resolver.delete. Resolver.delete will internally call the delete method of content provider. Content provider's delete method is going to call the delete method of SQLite database. You are done, right? So the thing which we need to understand over here, it goes like delete operation. So I can also print the value of I. So I'm also printing this value of I. Delete operation is happening where? It is happening in the database, in the table. It is not happening in the array list. It is not happening in the array list, right? So I'm going to run the code and we will see what I am trying to say. Alright, so here we are. So you say all users, and now I am going to say let's delete this guy number 3, Jim. You say delete user, so it says delete Jim, are you sure to delete the record? I said delete it, so it says Jim deleted from DB with 1. 1 means 1 recorded, but here you cannot see the guy deleted, right? So you are still able to see this guy Jim. It means table say data is deleted, but from my array list data is not deleted. So how I will do that? In order to do that, you come up here and you check for I, right? So you must check for I. I should be greater than 0. It means that record is deleted. So if value of I is greater than 0, what I am going to do, I am going to say user list dot remove the guy from the position, and then you say adapter dot notify data set changed. You are removing that object from the array list on that position on which you click. Adapter dot notify data set change will reconstruct the views of your list view. So over here I'm not running, but if you go back and you try to come back again, you will see that number 3 is deleted, but at the same instant of time it was not deleted. Now you rerun the code. Let's see what is the difference when you execute these instructions all together. Alright, so you say all users. You select the record number 6. And now you say, let's not select 6, let's select 5. Delete the user. Delete Kim, are you sure to delete the record? You say delete. Deleted. Clear, guys? How you are supposed to delete the record? In my last part, I need to update the record. In order to update the record, we must understand that we need to open the same activity where the user was inserting the record. That is how an update operation will happen. So what you want to update? So I am going to open the same activity. So what I will do, I will create an intent over here. I will say intent. Intent is a new intent. And now this intent goes from all users activity to your sign up activity. Right? And then you say start the activity with the intent. But I will not do only this job. I am going to say intent dot put extra key user comma user. So which user you want to update, right? So that user is available over here. But this guy will not allow me to put extra over here. In order to do that, what we will do, guys? We will say the user implements serializable, the forward passing technique which we studied right in the beginning. So in case one activity has to share the data to the other activity and that to a user defined object, it must be a serializable. Now when all users activity over here, if you can see, all users activity is going to launch the new activity, that's like sign up activity. So I'll open my sign up activity now. In its onCreate method, so this goes like your onCreate method, I'm going to say intent RCV assign get the intent. I get the intent first of all. Now I'm going to create one Boolean variable which is update mode. So just give me a moment, I'll bring the charger. So I created one Boolean variable called update mode. So this is one variable update mode. And now you say update mode assign RCV dot has extra key user. So I'm trying to distinguish whether the user is going to register or update. So if the user is going to update, then there might be an intent which will have key user, because from all user activity, you are actually starting the activity called sign up activity by passing key user. So when I am going to come back to my sign up activity, I got this guy called update mode. Now, if the mode is update mode, so in case your mode is update mode, right, what I will do? I will create one more user which is receive user. So this receive user, this guy goes like RCV user assign RCV dot get serializable extra on key user, and I will downcast this guy back to the user. And now your fields etxt name dot set the text RCV user dot get the name, let's say etxt email and password. Let's try to run the code and see what is the difference. I'm just going to give a run and we'll see one difference what has happened as of now. So in my all users activity, if the user is going to select the third option, that's the second index called update user, what we are doing, we are creating an intent, we are starting sign up activity. On the key user, we have kept the reference variable user, that's pointing to an object which contains data retrieved from the database. And then you start an activity. When you start an activity over here, which is your sign up activity, in my sign up activity, I am checking whether there exists a key or not. If it is existing, so you say your update mode will go true. Now, in case the update mode is true, I am receiving the same object and I am extracting the data and I am putting it onto my edit text, right? So if you try to come here, you say all users and you say let's come to Fiona and let's say update user, and you can see Fiona, fiona@example.com, and then you got your password, but we didn't do anything for the checkboxes, I mean radio button and the spinner. So we can also try to do something for radio button and spinner. So we'll see how we can do that now. So I will say if user dot get the gender dot equals male, you say rb male dot set check to true, and you can say rb female dot set check to false. In my else case, I'll do the vice versa, right? So this guy will be false and this guy will become true. This goes for the gender part. For the spinner, now for the spinner there is a twist. For a spinner there is a twist, because we need to show the same city. We need to show the same city. So I will take one variable called I, which is 0. This is index. And now I will say for int I assign 0, I less than adapter dot get the size, I mean get the count, I plus plus. So I have created one for loop. So adapter is here, right? So adapter contains the data. Now I will say if adapter dot get the item at I dot equals to user dot get the city. In case user city matches to the adapter's item, so I will record that position and I will break the loop. So whatever the position is matching for the city, I will put it into the index and I will break the loop. And thereafter I will say sp city dot set the selection to be the same index. At the same time you say button sign up dot set the text update user. Let's now run the code and see what will happen. All right, so now you say all users and let's say Fiona. And let's say update the user, and we got a crash. So let's see where is this crash. Yeah, my bad guys, this is not user, right? So this is receive user, right? So please rectify this. So over here also it's receive user. All users over here, you say Fiona again, update the user, and now you can see Fiona, email, password, you can see the gender which is highlighted and the city. Let's come back and let's try to say John Watson. You say update user, you can see the details of the John, mail and Chandigarh, right? So this goes on as in your update profile, so you need to say update user. So you can also update this guy. So you can point to the text view and you can update the text view in the update mode. Now for my update operation, so when the user is going to click on the button sign up, what is happening? So when user clicks on button sign up, what is called? Insert user. I come back to my insert user. I'm exactly in the same structure, insert user. So let everything goes in the same manner. Let everything goes in the same manner. So what I am going to do, I'm going to come here and I'm going to say is the mode update mode, if and else. So if the mode is update mode, so update operation should happen, else what should happen? insert operation, right? So I am going to take this insert operation and I am going to put in the else part. And over here I will say string where condition, which goes like util dot column underscore id, which should match with whatever the user you have received his or her id. It's the same id which we did for delete operation. We use the same concept for the delete operation with the where condition. Now what is next? You say resolver dot update. You pass three things: util dot user URI, then the same guy content values, and then you got the where condition and null. So it's basically the same structure as in your insert operation, but with the where condition. When you will say resolver dot update will update, will call the update method of content provider, and within the content provider you get the table name, which is the last path segment, and then you say SQLite database dot update. So this guy will take table name, then the content values, and then the where condition, and last guy goes null. This guy is also returning us some integer variable which you can return back. And in my all users activity, in my sign up activity, so you'll return the same integer over here. So if I is greater than 0, you can show a toast. User dot get name updated successfully, right? And here you can just try to display this guy I, and thereafter I will finish my activity. So you need not to show that activity, right? So you just finish it off. Let's run the code now and see what will happen. Alright, so let's come to the all users, and now I'm going to select this guy called, let's say Jenny, update the user. So Jenny Watson, let's say Jenny Jackson, right? So email ID is jenny@example.com, and let's say the gender, let's try to change the gender as male, and let's say update user. So it says Jenny Jackson updated successfully with ID 1, but Jenny Jackson is not updated here because you updated in the table but not into the list view, right? You try to go back and you try to come back with the users. Now you can see the new record as Jenny Jackson, and when you click on to the Jenny Jackson, you try to view the user. You can see the email ID is updated and the gender has gone to. This goes like your update operation, but there is one twist which is remaining. You need to update the record in the array list. Now that you will do yourself, right? So that I'm not gonna do. Let's see once again what we have done for the update operation. Let's review. In my all users activity, if someone is going to click on the update user, so update user will start an activity called sign up activity, and you are going to pass the key user over here, and then you say start activity with the intent. Now you need to mark your user class as serializable so that you can forward pass the data. In my sign up activity, I will come in the onCreate method and I will receive the intent, and I will check is there any key user available or not. So if it is available, the update mode will go as true. So if update mode, you extract the object and you put it as in receive user, and you set all your UI components with the values. So spinner is a bit twist. Why? Because here you need to check which city is matching with the which item of the adapter. You get the index and you set the selection on that index. In the spinner, what we are doing, we are iterating in the adapter. adapter is already having cities. Which city is user having if it is going to match with the adapter's item? So that corresponding index, I am saving it into the index. And thereafter, you put a break. And now you say set selection of the same index on SP city. This is how we are setting up the selection on the spinner. Moving ahead, you have also updated the text of your button, which goes like update user. Now, when you click on the button sign up, what happens? Insert user is executed. On insert user, I'm doing the same story, but in case it is update mode, so you put a where condition. And the where condition, you are saying resolver.update with the where condition. So this is similar to your insert method, but with one extra thing which goes like your where condition over here. Resolver.update will call the update method of content provider. And update method of content provider will internally call the update method of SQLite database. And hence, you will be returned back with the value I, which you are checking if it is greater than 0. User has been updated. In my else part, you can create some else part. And you can also say user could not be updated successfully, right? So if user is updated successfully, you say finish. And once we are done with this, so you will be able to see an updated change. So if you say update the user, but you won't be able to see it exactly over here because you need to refresh your list view. So if you go back and you reload your example, now you say view user, Jenny is back to the gender as female. So that's gonna be all for the day. Thank you very much.